What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you how can you create some ornaments and elements that are common in colonial architecture. So this is I guess you can say an architectural style, and it has all of these things like these you have these cornerstones, you have the balustrades, you have exposed rafters, and they have some really nice modeling that is kind of unique. We're going to be taking a look at the cornice details with dentils, and then also I'm going to be showing you how to create lintels for kind of above the window. And please, if I made any mistakes when it comes to naming all of these ornaments and elements, please correct me in the comment section below. Before we get into the actual tutorial, I would like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. On my website, if you're serious about learning Revit, you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got over 130 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. It's where I kind of get the time to go slowly, step by step, and explain all of the complex topics inside of Revit. Also there you can find some of my customized ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, and we also have a plugin which might interest you as well. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and as you can see, this is the this is just a simple house that they have created for this demonstration. And let's start with the cornerstones. I've also seen in some literature that it's also called coin or something like that, so that might be another term to search. So anyways, now let's start. So I'm going to be showing you two approaches. One is by using a family, and I actually have a course on this family, so let me show you. If you go here to place a component, you'll see I have this cornerstone adaptive family. You basically make sure that it's set here to place on face. You come to one of the wall faces, then you click at the edge. Okay, let's see here. Well, let's click here. And then if you extend it, what you'll see is it's going to create those cornerstones. Now there's two styles. This is one of the styles that they have for this family. And then I can rotate that, and let's extend it a little bit to this side. So I think it's not aligned with one of the sides of the wall, but that's okay. We just go here to the align tool. We pick this side, we pick this, and as you can see, this is what that looks like. So this is how you create those cornerstones. Now, as I said, this is a family, and I have a course on how you create this adaptive family. It's on my website, and I'm going to be linking it up in the cards above if you want to check it out. Now, of course, you don't have to use this family. You can do it manually, so I'm going to be showing you that on the other side of the house. So what you want to do is go to the architecture tab, and there you want to go to the component tool and click on component, and expand it and go to model in place. And then what you want to do is select a category. I'm just going to go with generic models, and then click OK. And let's just leave the name as is. Okay, so now what you want to do is you just want to make sure to set the work plane at level 1. Okay, then you go here to extrusion, and then let's go actually into level 1 and do this. So that's here on this side. So I'm going to go on one side, like, let's go with 0.5. half a meter, and then let's make it 4 centimeters thick. And then on the other side, let's go something smaller, like 0.2, and then again 4 centimeters thick. And then we can kind of connect this here. So it's going to be, is it the same size? Okay, it might be a bit smaller than the other one. That's perfectly fine. Then you want to go to the 3D view just to see what we have here. Hit finish, and it's going to expand like this. So it's 25 centimeters high. And let's say we're happy with this. Okay, so once you have this one created, then what you want to do is you want to kind of fix the edges. So you go here to create void forms, and then you go to void sweep. So here you can just go with pick path, and then you just want to pick out the kind of the exterior lines all the way around. Then you want to hit finish, and you want to go to edit profile. So for edit profile, you just want to zoom in, go to the side, then go 45 degrees down, go up, so you have a triangle. It's basically going to carve away that triangle all the way around. Then you just want to hit finish and hit finish again, and this is what we get. This is that cornerstone. Okay, so once we have this, then what you want to do is hit the tab key once to select just the original shape without the void. You can go to one of the elevations, like the south elevation, and then I'm just going to copy this, make sure to uncheck constrain, and copy it here from the bottom up. Just like that. Okay, so it's now, yeah, it's exactly in its place. Okay, so now you want to select this shape and then you want to go to edit extrusion. Then let's go into level 1, that's perfectly fine. And now you just want to switch it. So here on this side, so from here to here should be 0.5, so that's 50 centimeters, and here should be 0.2, I think we've used, or did we? So let me check here. So we used, yeah, 0.2. Okay, perfect. And then you hit finish. Go to the 3D view, and now this is what we have. Okay, so once you have this, you again just do the same thing with the voids. I'm just going to skip that part. And this is basically what we have. So we have two of these, and then I can just hit finish. And now I can select this thing, I can go to one of the elevations, zoom out, go to copy, check multiple, and then uncheck constrain, and then you can simply go from here and copy that up. So usually I like to copy this 3 or 4 times, then I like to make a selection of only those, and then copy it again. So it's just a bit quicker to copy when you're copying like 4 of these than just one. There we go, and then perhaps one more here. Okay, and then if you kind of overdo it as I did here, I can just delete these, perhaps this one as well. And there we go. So now we have something that looks like this. So yeah, these are a bit smaller than the other ones, but you get the point. So this is kind of the manual way, it takes a bit longer, and if you wanna do it with a family, you can do that. And of course, if you want to get this whole model, so including the family, including the house and so on, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to include the link to just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Okay, so moving forward, let's now talk about another really important element, and that is these exposed rafters. So we have these rafter tails, I guess you can call them, and usually they don't look like this. So this is very simple, very straightforward, and usually you want to make this a bit more complicated and a bit nicer. So you have multiple approaches to this. One approach would be to use a reference plane and then carve it out. Now this approach only works if you have a basic simple cut, so let me show you. So if I go to my level 1 and let's create a section through this thing, so let's just run a quick section through the house. Okay, open that up. So here you want to make sure that you're in the fine level of detail so you can see those beams. Okay, so for these beams, if I want to make a simple cut, I can just go here to reference plane, create a reference plane that kind of follows that cut that I want to make, like so, and then I can simply go here to modify, cut geometry. You want to make sure you select multiple cut, and then you click on the, let's see, click on the reference plane, and then we click on this, and then we select the rest of these beams. There we go. And then if I go to the 3D view, you can see this is what that did. So it kind of made it just a horizontal cut at the bottom. Now that is okay, but that's not very exciting. So what do you do if you want to have something that's a bit nicer, a bit cooler? So let me do that here on this one. Now this approach requires you to use a cut by face or an opening by face. You just click on that. You select the vertical face here, and then you can kind of carve away. So I can start from here, for example, I can go in a little bit, then I would switch to the tangent and arc, and then you can go perhaps like this, see? And then you can go like this, and then you can switch to a regular line, and then go with that line like so, and then finish it like that, and so on. And then you just want to make sure you kind of connect it on the other side, so, oops, let's see, okay, there we go, something like this. And then when you hit finish, you get that kind of carved away look on this beam. Now, the downside of this thing, I haven't figured out a way where you can copy this to the other ones, so you would basically have to do this manually. What you can do, just to kind of save time, if I go here into Edit Sketch, you should be able to select this sketch, Control C to copy, hit finish here, okay, and then when I go to the second one and go to Opening by Face, click here to select. Now I should be able just to paste that in place. Oops. And then you might have to go to a section to just align it properly. Okay, not this section. So let's create a new, oh, we don't have a section. Okay, this is annoying, but you get the point. So you can just kind of paste it there. And then I think I can use one of the elevations. Yeah, okay, perfect. So you can kind of align it there. So select it and then just align it like so. Okay, so that's kind of a way to save time where and just to make sure that they all look the same. So there we go. That's how we can play around with these rafter tails and make them look a bit more elegant. Okay, so now here we can see we have this wall sweep, and let's say we want to add some repeating elements here. So this, if I'm not mistaken, is called cornice, and then those kind of repeating elements are called dentils. Okay, so I'm going to be showing you how to do that. Now, first on how to create this sweep, I already have a video on that, and I've just recorded it recently. So if you want to check that out, I'm going to include a link to that just up in the cards above. So now, how to create the repeating element? Well, you have a couple of different approaches. The one that I'm going to use is a very simple one, which is to create a family for that. So let's go here to new, family, and this is going to be a very simple, straightforward family. So let's go here to generic model, like so. So just a simple generic model. And then what you want to do with this is just create an extrusion that's here kind of centered, so just like this. So I want this thing to be 25 millimeters on both sides here, making it 50 in total. So this should be 50, like so, and then the height should be 50. So it's like a 50 by 50 by 50 square. Okay, so once we have this family created, so okay, let's go and save it. So save the family. Let's call it, I don't know, small cube or, okay. Now, once we have that saved, I can load that into the project and close it. So this is the house, okay. And then I'm just going to kind of place it wherever. So let's just place it like this here at the corner. Okay, so once we have this, now I can go to the south elevation. I can move it up, so here we have that, so just move it all the way up. So because it's a generic family, it's not going to be constrained by anything. So I can just move it here, like so, align it there. I think I want to align it like this. So let's see if I can just align it with this line here. Perfect. And then let's go to the 3D view just to see where that is. Okay, it's there. So let's go to our section and then align it just by using the align tool here, like so. And then finally, we can go to our south elevation and we can repeat this. So let's actually go to the edge, like so. Okay, so now you want to select this, you want it to go to array, you want to set it to last. You can group and associate so you can change it later on. And then let's say we should repeat this 100 times. Okay, so you select it here and then you just drag it to the other side and place it there. And it's just going to place a ton of those elements and it's going to look like this. So now if I go to the 3D view, it's going to look like that. So if you feel like it's perhaps one too many, you can select any one of these and then you can reduce the number. So if you go with 80, so it's just going to be kind of less of them. So that's how this is going to look. So you can create those kind of repeating detail elements. Okay, so now let's talk about windows and lintels, or you know, those elements that are above the window. It's usually a structural element, a beam that's inside of the wall, but in older buildings, we used to have them more exposed, and it's just a nice ornament element. So let me show you how you build one of those. So that's going to be built as a family also. So let's go here to File, to New, and then go to Family. Now, in this case, because it's going to be above the window, so it's going to be on a wall, so it makes sense to make it a wall-based family. So you just go here to generic wall-based, you select that category, and then you hit open. So it's going to look like this. It's going to give you a wall. Then you can go to the placement side, and on the placement side, you go to extrusion. You want to make sure to set the work plane to pick a plane, and then pick that face so that placement side face of the wall. Then I like to make just a simple rectangle to kind of figure out the size, and then I can say, okay, so let's say I want this to be 120 in total, so 600, and then 120 or 1200, yeah. Okay, so once we have this in place, I like to make the cornerstone here as well. So this is just another kind of famous element that's quite popular to have on these. So it's like a corner, or not the cornerstone, it's the keystone, the one in the middle that kind of keeps the whole thing from collapsing. At least it used to in the past. Here it's basically just an ornament. So anyways, let's select this, and then I'm just going to mirror that. Or yeah, I want to copy. Okay, so just like that. So that's going to be here in the middle, and then these sides, I might want to kind of have them the same angle as this thing. So what I'm going to do now is I just want to keep kind of this shape. So what I'll do is I'll delete these two lines on top and bottom, and then I'm going to use the trim and extend to corner. So that's this tool over here, and just trim it like so. Delete this, select this shape, go to mirror, copy, and then mirror it around like so. And then finally, you want to make sure that the extrusion end is set to something like 15 millimeters. Hit apply, finish. There we go. So now, if I open up the 3D view here, it's going to look like this. So this is kind of our starting point. So let's go back to the placement side, and now let's go to create, and let's build that kind of keystone. So you just want to use pick lines like so, go to trim and extend to corner, and do this. Basically, okay. And then you can just kind of extend it up a little bit, and then extend it even down a little bit if you want. Okay. So once we have this, for the extrusion end, I'm going to go with 50 millimeters because this should be kind of more massive, I guess. And then finally, we want to have, let's go to the 3D view. We want to have something else here. So what I'll do is go to create, extrusion, set work plane, pick a plane, click OK, and then let's set this face here. And then I'll use the pick lines, use the tab key to select the entire face of this, and then just bring this up, and I'll have it be 15 millimeters. Okay, select that, go to the placement side, and then just mirror it here. Okay, just like so. Okay, and then for the extrusion end, let's go with 15 millimeters there as well, and hit finish. Okay, so now that's going to look something like this. Now you want to join all of this together, so go to join geometry, and then just join it all. And then you can assign materials. I'm not going to do that in this moment, and then let's go to save, to save that family, and I'm just going to call this the lintel. Hit save, okay, and then just load that into the project. Click OK. And now what you'll see is if I go to the 3D view, I can just place that above any windows, and I can use it and then reuse it, and I can use it for multiple windows. And it doesn't matter, is it like a short window, tall window, I can always move this around and place it exactly where I want that family to be. So there you go. Those are some kind of tips and tricks and workflows that you can use when it comes to creating this sort of ornaments for kind of colonial style architecture. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarctic.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.